Welcome to the February 15th meeting of the Community Preservation Committee. As there is no general public present, there is no general public comment. We have the minutes that Sarah sent to us this morning, I believe, from the November 16th meeting. Is there a motion to accept the minutes?
So moved.
A second?
Second.
Discussion?
I just have a question. I have a couple of questions. One of them really doesn't have to do with the accuracy, the not accuracy of the minutes. It has to do with the $150,000 set aside for each of the three areas.
Where is that?
I was reading the financial review and something came to mind, so it's just a question I have. It has nothing to do with whether that's accurate or not. My question was, is that a state mandate or is it a local, those figures?
The percentages?
Yeah, that's 150.
So the 10% is the state mandate,
that's what,
which for us is about 150,000.
Yeah, that's what I wanted to know.
For those three categories.
Right. Wait a minute, I have another question.
While you're thinking, Ann, the gentleman who just came in, did you have a comment for us? A general public comment that
I'm Clint Clay with Grow Food Northampton.
Oh, okay. So if you want to just sit tight for just a little bit.
Sure, yeah, I apologize for being late.
Great, good. Thank you, Clint.
This, on page two, where we were dealing with the courthouse, we talked at one point about the September deadline, but we actually mandated the September deadline. And I wondered if on page two at the top, in the top portion of that page, if when we moved and seconded the project, whether it ought to indicate at that point that we mandated the September deadline on it, because we got that out there and I thought maybe it ought to be reflected in the minutes that we did that, not just talked about it.
So that'd be the last line. Jeff moved to fund the project $100,000, second by David O. Motion included funds being expended by September, what did you say, 15th?
It was the 30th, I thought, but I don't remember what it was. Do you think it matters? I mean, that was really my question.
We can add it.
Okay.
Anything else, Anna?
Nope.
Any other discussion on the minutes for November the 16th? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Chair's report, the only thing that I wanted to say is folks following the city council meeting of almost 13 days ago will note that the wage theft was brought before city council, and they have asked us, requested us, quite sure what the language was, to come up with some sort of policy. The city solicitor, right? Mayor and city solicitor will be coming before us?
Yeah, they're working on policies citywide, so we can use those as a starting point rather than starting from scratch.
Right.
Possibly doing something questionable.
Good.
So that would really be definitely in an upcoming meeting once we have those.
I don't know if this needs to be a motion, but I suggest that we would best be informed by the city solicitor and mayor on this topic, and well, I look forward to addressing it.
Well, they will come before us, is what the
right.
It's definitely
yeah,
going to happen.
What I said, and from that, we would hopefully, they would come before us with proposed language that would meet legal standards and fairness standards also to employees who might be so affected. I would suggest that we table the discussion of this until we have that guidance and then,
yes.
Then act on that, those recommendations.
Yes. And I think that is the intent. Maybe we can.
Brian?
Yeah, sorry.
I think it would be, it might be a good idea to also ask Lisa Clausen to come in.
Yes.
She's contacted some of us and it would be good to hear her perspective and presentation as well.
Yes, and I did, she emailed me, should she come in tonight? And I said, no, because it's not on the agenda, but then we will inform you when it is and be sure to have her there.
Good.
Maybe when we look at the, our schedule of meetings, which comes a little later on in the meeting agenda, we can make sure that we have a time set aside for that discussion. Does that make sense? All right, that's it for that. Request for contract extension from Grow Food Northampton. This also came, Sarah sent this out by email, and Clem can speak to this in just a moment, thank you. So for those who haven't been here for a while, we funded Grow Food Northampton for creation of the Organic Community Garden Plot Thorns 5 years ago,
mm-hmm.
is that right? And as with all of, I think all of our contracts, we have a 3-year mandate to expend all money. A year ago, Grow Food came back and asked for another year's extension to spend down the balance of the grant, which we voted to allow. And now Grow Food Northampton is back again because there's still 10,700 whatever balance of the original grant. Clem, do you want to, so we've had, hopefully we've had a chance to look at this, but Clem, if you want to speak and tell us.
Thank you.
Why?
Yes, I'd be happy to do that. Thanks for having me. So yeah, everything that that was just stated is correct. We had intended to spend the full remaining balance out in 2016, and I think the short version of why we're struggling to spend it out is because there's no staff time in there, and it takes a lot of effort to manage these projects, and so we end up doing them one at a time. And as any of you who were here back in 2015 might remember, we had a real battle with the Department of Agricultural Resources over a shed that we were building with this funding. We got delayed for a long time. They eventually issued in 2016 a certificate of approval to do that shed. We didn't resolve all the other sort of existential issues that they raised with their from their legal counsel, but we did get sort of that one item through. We're able to build it. It's beautiful, and we're very grateful to the Community Preservation Fund for having supported it. That took us through till September, and then we moved on to the remaining projects that we were that we had in the queue. I'm sort of conservative about these things, so I didn't want to, in case the shed ran over, I didn't want to overcommit to other projects. But so we did a bunch of research in October and November on developing some frost-free water infrastructure. We have, again, thanks to the CPA, we have a network of spigots in the garden that serve all gardeners. Everybody's got one, you know, within a couple of plots walk from their own plot. But those were only installed sort of at the 18-inch or so depth, and so they're subject to frost. So the next priority project for us is still in the irrigation category, but providing limited service closer to the road, because we're not going to redo the whole system, but to try to provide it below the frost line in a limited way so that gardeners can at least access some water outside of the sort of May through late October or early November time when we turn the water off if they need it, and also to serve some of the small leaseholders on that same parcel that's part of the larger CPA proposal. So we just didn't get far enough with that before we were not able to get a trench permit, because DPW does not issue those once the asphalt factories or suppliers are shut down for the season, which happens earlier than I had realized. So that was sort of the issue that we ran into. So we're ready to go with that project and then have a couple of possible projects we would spend any remaining part of the balance on this year. And that would be either a hoop house, which would serve the garden very well. We had originally thought of a much larger sort of greenhouse project, and with all the trouble we ran into with ag resources, we're thinking much more modestly, but there would still be a lot of benefits to having that. And there are some other things that if we didn't do that would fall within the original budget and proposal in terms of care of the riverfront area and cover cropping for soil building on some of the areas that are not as easy on that south parcel to use for commercial agriculture. So we're confident we can, if you'll grant us an extension, that we will finish it all out this year, because we don't have the shed project hanging over us the way we did for the better part of 2 years. And so we're hoping that you'll look kindly upon that request one last time and let us finish building the infrastructure out there, which has been just, as I said in the letter, it's just been tremendously valuable to have that investment over the long haul from CPA to meet needs out there in the garden and build out the infrastructure. We've got a pretty happy crop of gardeners and small farmers out there as a result.
Okay, so I wasn't here before. Where are we located?
Oh, I'm so sorry. I should have given that background. And I don't have a map to hand out, but I'll put, I can pass
you
out
the Florence Field,
the original proposal.
Yeah.
Yeah,
adjacent to the Florence Field.
Right. Yeah, yeah, exactly.
Been there that long.
So this is where the fields ended up,
yeah.
And this is where the
yeah, no, I know where
is.
That
yeah.
Is.
Yeah, okay. And
can I ask you a couple of questions? I was here, but my memory doesn't go to this detail. It sounds as though you're looking for new projects to help expend the remaining 10,000.
I would say really they're just projects that fit within the framework of that original proposal, which I'm happy to hand around if anybody wants to look at it.
And you've done a marvelous job, but I'm just
I understand what you're saying.
Real asset to the community. We're not probably that open to extra projects that aren't clearly part of the original project.
Right. All the things that I mentioned are actually in the original budget, one way or another. And I would say, about irrigation, the attempt was made to stretch the money so it would be available to other projects, and that was where the decision to, because going below the frost line for the full network would have been prohibitively expensive, and a lot of other things that were in the proposal and that we have done over the years would not have been able to be done if we'd gone that deep.
Educator, stupid guy, because this is town money, not our money.
Sure.
If somebody says, you want to put in deep pipes so that people can irrigate the garden during deep freezes. What do I say? What do I say to somebody?
Yeah, no, absolutely. It's actually a great question. So right now, what we do with the system that we have is, if there's even going to be a light frost,
blow it out.
We turn the whole thing off and drain it, and so that becomes a lot of extra effort. But more importantly, it feels very risky. And so, to be conservative, we tend to shut the water off sooner than we really need to, so that we don't blow up the system that you bought, the public bought, and put the whole thing at risk. So, but every time we do turn it back on, because it looks like we have a few days of warm weather, we then have to watch it, worry about it. And so in some ways we're trying to, make up for the deficiencies of that system and offset those, mitigate those risks by having something close to the road that isn't as convenient for gardeners, but provides for the needs that gardeners have during those times when we might get an early, either a late frost in the spring or an early frost in the in the fall. Some folks like to get started early with things, and they depend on the water. Maybe we turn it on once, and then we turn it back off. Those kinds of things.
The risers on a deep buried system be just as susceptible to frost as they would be on an 18-inch system?
If you'd like, I can show you all my research on frostproof hydrants and things like that. Yeah, so that's sort of where we're headed. But again, we can't afford to put those all over the garden or extend that network underground deep into the garden. The idea is to keep it close to the road, make it accessible for gardeners, and also for the small farm operations that are on the same property and are also addressed in that grant in terms of trying to meet their needs. They obviously have benefit from having water available outside of the normal gardening season for their operations, so. But thank you for asking that question, because you're right, it does defy sort of common sense on the face of it, so.
And you, just, you already have the quotes for the work, for the.
I do.
So, are you anticipating that you're gonna be able to stretch the money further? I mean, you're, I hear you're hoping, you have a quote.
So, the number, I don't have the exact numbers in my head, but the range of quotes on the water from a couple of different, a couple of different excavators were from 5 to 12,000. Obviously, we're going with the guy who was down at the 5 range, but I always expect when I go with the low bidder that it's gonna run over some. So I'm, my, you know, my anticipated range for that project is 5 to 8. And so I'm expecting that we would have somewhere between 3 and 6 left over. And as I mentioned, the hoop house is one of the things that was in the original budget that we just had sort of put off and put off, because we had, at one point, imagined rather than doing that, we might build a larger greenhouse, bring in additional funds outside of the CPA to do that, and we've sort of backed off of that. But if we were to, let's say the irrigation was on the high end of the range, and we didn't think we had enough left over toward a hoop house, there are other projects still undone on that larger proposal and budget that we could, you know, be very happy to invest money in, that we just sort of have off, particularly sort of taking care of some of the low-lying areas closer to the Mill River, mm-hmm. in terms of you know, soil building, establishing, you know, crops that are not productive crops per se, but maybe more like a hay or straw type of crop. Mm-hmm. That right now we have a lot of weed issues, and then we have, of course, like everybody, invasives coming in.
Right. Mm-hmm.
What was the original amount of the grant?
104,500.
And when you got a, you amended this with a 1-year extension?
Twice, I believe this is the, that's right. So
this is your second one right now?
Sarah, can you help me out here? Because I've only been here 2 years, so I want to make sure I get it right. It could be that this is our third,
okay,
or it could be that this is our second.
I think it's the second.
I think it's the second, too.
Okay.
So do you know what the amount was at the time you did the first amendment, and where you are since then?
It was 36.
You're down to 10,000 and
change. It was 36 last year, and we spent about 25, this in round numbers. On the shed and several other things that fit in with that as well, that we spent down last year, and then sort of held up on the irrigation piece of things.
Okay, thank you.
Other questions for Clive? Thank you so much. Is it
appropriate if I hand out things about garden registration and other things going on, or is that not?
Sure, whatever you're.
If anybody wants any of these things, I would pass them on.
Just to reiterate what Clem said, I'm a community gardener up at Hospital Hill Plot, and it's very tough early in, if you're getting stuff in the March or April without water on. Okay. Because we have to bring all the water up in our car to get our peas and our spinach in. And that's.
To get them started?
Yeah, it's really very difficult. Physically very difficult. Water is very heavy, and to have to transport it into the car and then out. So, just to reiterate that.
Can we take a vote on this one?
Yes.
Your name, Nick Morgan.
Please.
Not to expound too long, but I'd like to move to approve. There's been a change of leadership. We've delayed the expenditure to reflect the current applicant. And. It is a marvelous project, which has lived up to its expectations in the community, and it's a real asset to the community and fulfilled a necessary and much wanted expansion of access to gardening plots for the community. And that, I believe, the money has been cared for carefully. And not spent frivolously, and I also believe that there have been satisfactory answers to almost the questions that I asked the applicant. So I would like to move that we approve with the understanding that, that all monies must be spent within the next fiscal year, otherwise they will revert to the future use of the Community Preservation Commission.
What do you mean by the next fiscal year?
I can't hear you.
What do you mean by the next fiscal year?
Next, I don't know, is it June 30th?
Yeah, they start July 1st. So what do you mean, July 1st of 2018?
Can you, what's the outside for expenditure?
I would like to say we could spend it all by June 30th, and we will if we need to, or we'll return it. But having into the fall would be helpful to complete the irrigation first and see what's left.
What's a realistic date?
I think realistic would be, you know, by October or November.
End of the calendar year.
The end of this calendar year.
Yeah,
I think there should be some finite limit,
sure.
But I also don't want to put you under a gun.
Thanks.
Second.
So the motion on the floor is to allow Grow Food Northampton a essentially 10.5 month extension to spend by the end of the calendar year the $10,790.78 of the original grant. Do I understand that?
Mm-hmm.
There's a motion and a second. Is there any discussion, further discussion? All those in favor? Opposed? Okay.
Thank
you. You are more than welcome to stay for the rest of our meeting.
And more than welcome to
stay. You don't have anything to do, right?
Thank
you very much. No. I appreciate it.
All right. Thank you, Clem, and good luck with your gardening.
Thank you. We've got a final report.
Sarah, I'm not quite understanding the next item on the agenda, Q&A for applicants.
This is if any applicants for the current round feel like coming to talk to the committee and ask any questions, but that generally they don't do that. But I put it on the agenda just because
it's nice. And now we have just done that so we can cross it off our agenda.
It is done.
Always nice to make lists that you can cross things off. Okay, so we have three small grant applications that are in front of us. Chris, did you get?
I did.
Did you get those? Okay. None of which we have seen. Do people feel comfortable looking over these in the next 10 or so minutes now and making a decision? Is that okay? One is long, but.
The one with the binder clip has a lot of attachments, but isn't actually very long.
Is this appropriate to read now and make decisions?
How about we read them and then see if we're all comfortable making the decision?
Okay. All right. So here we go.
And I'm going to finish handing out the larger applications.
And altogether for this, we have how much money?
I think these come in at $6,500. Two for $3,000 and one for $500.
Okay.
Is that correct?
So it isn't a question of there being a cap there and. It's a question of whether we have
this much money. We
don't
have a lot of money.
That's exactly what I was going for.
And again, and our limit in small grants is the total project cannot exceed $6,000.
Yeah.
The grant from CPC cannot exceed $3,000.
Okay. Thank you.
Did you get the larger grants?
Okay.
So it's just the three, Sarah?
Yeah.
Sarah, where is Ventures Field Road?
There's a good map on the back.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I can't.
It's,
I'm still.
Because that's 91, and this is Pomeroy Terrace here, so it's down in that. It's sort of like adjacent to the Three County Fair.
Oh, okay. I got it. Thank you. Jail Farm, that's most restaurant.
Jail Farm?
No, it has to.
Where is?
Don't insult her.
You think the screen was frozen or
something? Everybody freeze for 5 minutes from now. Seen the Aero Shop? There's a wonderful movie that relies on that now called Lion, where the true story of a young man.
David, we are reading.
Yep.
Yes.
I have school for you.
Was that a dollar amount, Chef?
Yes, it was.
Yeah, I did this.
How are we doing in the small grant stuff? Some folks have moved on to the other things. Do people need more time? Anne, are you
looking for? I'm looking, obviously, this later one is a extension of something that's already gone on, so you guys are familiar with it.
We're not all familiar with it, Anne.
Let us know when you're good to go, Anne.
Not to single you out or anything.
Not to single me out or anything, that's true.
No.
Please get started, that's perfectly all right.
Take your time.
I'll catch up.
Can I have the larger grants? Is that a copy?
Did I not?
Does anyone need a little more time? Okay, we can begin discussion. First, Sarah, can you refresh our memory, if you will, how much money we have?
We have about $90,000.
About $90,000. And we have before us three projects, two for $3,000 and one for $500. So that would take, if if we were to fully fund it, that would be 6,500 less. So we'd be down to 83,500 or something. Okay. So in no particular order, let's go through the three of these. Does it matter which order we go through? No. Let's start with the Lathrop community one first.
Can I give some background to that?
Please.
To the request, this is a few years ago, Lathrop received a grant from us after some discussion for the development of trails on their property that was clearly showed a lot of good planning, and it also, the application was accompanied by clear language of the way in which the trails would be publicly accessible, so that this was not simply a project for Lathrop community members, but also for the general public, and we supported that. This is seems to be a follow-up on that request.
Sarah, do we know how much folks outside of Lathrop use the trails?
They use them a great deal at the Fitzgerald Lake entrance. I don't know about the piece shown in this area, the Bassett portion. I don't know how many people actually come out there. It would be hard to get to unless you're coming from Lathrop, so we do mostly people coming into the museum.
You have to find parking in Lathrop. We did it once before I joined this committee. We went out there just because we had heard about these as hiking trails, or walking trails, not really hiking trails. And the trick is driving into Lathrop community, figuring out where to park to access the trailhead, because nothing's clearly marked.
Yeah.
You can go and you can walk, and also the trails aren't actually all connected. So you walk a trail and then you walk through the parking lot and then you walk another trail and then you're behind someone's dwelling. And then you kind of come out of places. But you can also see where they're planning to do more as you go walking through there. And some of that shows up on the map.
Planning to do more what?
To do more work to develop the trails and to develop, like they've started putting benches out there so you can just sit and enjoy the, you know, there's a vernal pool. There's a certified vernal pool out there. That was why we were going out there, was to check out the vernal pool. So they're putting benches so people can sit and enjoy the vernal pool and some other benched areas which look out over fields that used to be agriculture. So they're, you know, they're trying.
So this is two different parcels, Sarah?
It's
right?
A different parcel than the previous award was. The previous award was for work at Fitzgerald Lake.
And this
or
is,
near Fitzgerald Lake.
And this is for the one that Julia was just referring
yeah.
to.
It's off Florence Road, yeah.
So I'm looking at that map and not having a good time figuring out what we're, because it keeps bouncing around among the things. Can you help me?
And toward the end, they have a back map, the walking trails at Lathrop, and I think that map is actually. So the most helpful. So see, there's, you know, as I said, we went in on that Mulberry Lane meadow and we wandered around that, but it wasn't contiguous to the number two trail, which we then went up to someone else's house, walked between things, and went out to the vernal pool. We were in search of the vernal pool. And when you get to the end of that number two, they've got a bench over that field and a wildflower garden that they're developing. It's really pretty. It's really lovely.
And this is all Northampton, in Northampton, is that correct?
It borders to East Hampton.
It's the East Hampton one with a little bit of Northampton.
Yeah.
Right, exactly. Right.
Yeah, okay, now I'm with.
Yeah.
But this, all this land that the invasive removal will take place is in Northampton, Sarah, is that correct?
That's what it seems to be framed as. Mm-hmm. It seems like they're getting completely different funds for their East Hampton portion of the work, and they keep it separate.
Yeah, they said.
Yeah. Are you concerned, Julia, that one, no one knows about this, and two, it's really
just open to Lathrop folks.
So it's open to anyone, but it's not well publicized, and it's, and the signage isn't all that great, you know. Mm. Park here to enjoy our public trails. Is, there's no sign that says that. And I, you know, I don't know a lot of other, I know most of the trails around Northampton, and I know people, I see people on them all the time. I know a lot of people who go out to Lathrop to just do a little walk on the trails. So I don't think it's got huge public access. It's not like
they're going to be doing very serious reconstruction of the big building out there, from what I understand.
The inn? Uh-huh. They redo the inn?
Yeah. Which probably will only complicate access, is all I'm thinking of. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, although, you know, we didn't park at the inn, we went back to the residences. Yeah, but
although there is parking at the inn. What do you think if there were a sign out on Florence Road that said public access trails, you know, with a big arrow pointing in, and then more signage?
I wonder how they'll
install that.
I bet they wouldn't like that, but I think that is what's needed. If we're putting public funds, you know, we've already put public funds into some of their other property, but if we put public funds into a property that they say has public access, then they need to let the public know.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah. Because there's nothing intuitive about that.
Yeah.
What about our traditional, this was funded by CPA, signage? Is there any of that out there?
Well, this is a new property. Do we have it at the, we should have it at the old, at the other Fitzgerald Lake, or contiguous to Fitzgerald Lake property.
Oh, so we've not done any work on these trails at all?
Correct. Is that correct, Sarah?
This is a different.
Making different property.
They
come before me for other things. I'm just trying to make sure.
On Bridge Road, but this is a completely different property.
It's a completely different property. Yeah. Why don't we get a motion on the floor here, and then we can discuss some further details.
It sounds like the intent of the proposal is noble on that to suppress invasive plants, and obviously that's kind of a winner idea. I think the point about its public accessibility is very important, and that should be a matter of discussion in this group as a major condition if we're to go forward with it.
So can we get a motion?
I move we accept the proposal to clear off the invasive species from the identified property in the Northampton section of Lathrop.
At full funding, 3,000?
At 3,000.
Okay, is there a second?
So.
Okay, Julie, a second?
So yeah. Their previous award was for both properties.
It was.
So it was a $3,000 award that was split between the Fitzgerald Lake area as well as this property.
Okay, so there's a motion and seconded for full approval. We are now in the discussion phase. Remember, with our small grants, we can vote to approve tonight. We can be somewhat confused about certain things and ask that it be bumped into the general round. So that is an option that we have. We can outright refuse, which doesn't mean they would prevent them from coming back, but not this. Not in this time frame. So those are our three choices.
And can you send it back to them asking them whether or not they would put a sign out front?
I think if we are to do that, I would suggest we just kick it into the round. This is a small grant. We deal with it tonight one way or the other.
I have a question. Is there any kind of insignia, sort of small or symbolic reference to trails that doesn't require a big wordy sign? I mean, like the Appalachian Trail has that sort of AT combination, and you don't have to write Appalachian Trail. You just see that little insignia, and you know that there's access to the trail is nearby. Is there something, because there seems like there are a number of places in the city where would be great to have an insignia like that. And it'd be simple, and once you know what you're looking for, it would be meaningful to anybody who's looking for a hiking trailhead. Is that, does such a thing exist?
Well, there's blazes at the trailheads of almost all the trails in Northampton. So, Mineral Hills has blazes. There's blazes on
Fitzgerald Lane.
Yeah, right. I mean, everything's been blazed. There's an amazing new blazing job up on the trails in Leeds that the Leeds Civic Association did. That's really remarkable.
So, is that, could we incorporate language of blazing?
The thing about the trailheads for every other place I just said are on the road.
Yeah.
The trailhead for Lathrop
yeah.
is at the back of the community.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. I have to say I like the idea a lot, sort of in general, and that sounds like a different small grant application that we might see at some time to sort of brand within
right.
the Northampton.
Yeah. Trailhead.
Yeah. And it's, you know, like yeah. the, like you're saying, the AT, it's got the hiker there with the,
right. mm-hmm.
with the hiking pole, and it's immediately recognizable. And so I think that's a great idea, and if that happened, it could also help in this situation. But I think they'd have to do something on their own at the moment.
Yeah.
To ensure.
We could bring that up when Jack is here. It's too bad Jack is not. Mm-hmm. It may be something that the CONSCOM could take up. Sarah, do you have comments on that? I mean, is that
as far as the blazing goes?
Well, as far as a branding insignia that would.
And we have standard signage that we put at every conservation mm-hmm. property, but it says this is privately owned, it would be more up to them. In the last application, the committee really focused on the Fitzgerald Lake property, which is really heavily used, so that it didn't really come up as much last time.
I would feel more comfortable kicking this down the road, throwing it into our general grant cycle, and having Barbara or someone from Lathrop come and speak to us about some of the concerns that we have.
Mm-hmm.
It just seems public access, from what Julie is saying, is
yep.
sketchy at best, and that perhaps it could be better addressed if someone can speak to that rather than us. Nonetheless, there's a motion on the floor to deal with this tonight, to fully fund it tonight. So further discussion on this? Yeah.
Just a couple of general observations. The first is, While I'm guided by the actions of previous commissions, I don't feel bound by them, so I consider this a new grant. And secondly, I'm not happy when people ask us for money and don't show up and let me ask these questions, even for a small grant.
That's the intent, though.
It doesn't make me happy, though. I'm allowed to feel unhappy.
But they're almost instructed not to come,
okay.
just because the committee may decide not to.
Absent Dave's, knowledge of the program and Julia's, personal experience there, all I have is this, and mm-hmm. that may be the way the small grant thing was designed. I wasn't here for the designing of it, and I like to have the opportunity to ask people what they're going to do with it. So that's just me. Particularly when I see it 5 minutes before I'm going to be asked to vote on it.
Any other discussion?
As part of the discussion, I like your idea, and I will probably vote no tonight. But I'm actually in support of the project. I think we do need to meet with the applicant and have a discussion about access, because that's a key. If you want, I mean, the dollar amount isn't that large. The purpose of the expenditure is noble. But it's all pointless if there's no public access. So that better accomplish through dialogue, I think.
No public usage. She would tell you there's public access.
No
public usage.
Yeah.
Which is different than.
Because I don't want this to look like the city spending even $1,000 on basically something for a separate entity's benefit. So I'm going to vote no on this particular, with the way this vote is formulated, but I'll vote yes on the project if there's another vote that includes having the applicant here.
So I'm going to agree with that, and I would love to have asked them questions. Like, one of the things I noticed is there are two letters of support, both dated from 2015. That's a long time ago. So are they for this application, or is that the previous application? I'm not, you know, there are a lot of things that aren't clear in this, and it's hard to, you know, if we had a different motion to defer it out and have them come in, great, but we have the motion to fund it.
I just put it out there to have it out there.
Oh, yeah.
Right, and that gets the discussion. That's what the motion's about. Get us talking.
So is the vote still, is the motion still standing?
Yes.
Okay.
Is there further discussion? All those in favor? All those opposed? So unanimous opposed. Is there a motion to kick this into the general?
So moved.
What we call general funding cycle. Is there a second?
Second.
Is there further discussion? All those in favor? All right. That was sort of interesting. Moving right along to the historic jail farm agricultural restoration. Sarah, can you put that back up again? Google Earth is so cool.
It's so much hard.
Throw up. So, wait, I'm still confused. There's 91, and where's town?
Town is to the left, down here.
Okay. We're going north on 91, past
treatment plant.
Right.
Oh, search your plan is there. Oh,
you
okay.
You could get to it two ways, right? You can go from the fairgrounds, or you could come off of Station 91 and turn down Henry. Yeah.
And that green thing, is it a green strip?
Yeah.
That lime green thing?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, so is there a motion for funding the jailhouse agricultural restoration?
So moved.
For full funding?
Yes.
Is there a second?
Second.
Discussion?
I'm wondering if Sarah can help interpret this map.
So it's like this.
But what it might, I'm wondering what those silver objects are that are.
The cars?
I looked at that from the
highway. They look like barns or tanks of some sort.
I'm just wondering, is that a neighbor encroaching, and is that a big issue?
Yeah, it seems like some of it is just junk, but some of it is the neighbor sort of moving their stuff over a period of years, it seems like.
You know, I looked at that same thing, and the question that I asked was, I see some cars, get them towed off, but is anything potentially hazardous?
Yeah, that, I mean, all of that is what I was wondering about. What's in this? This is for agriculture. The storage tanks of some sort?
Sure, is Wings intent that this would be leased to a farmer?
It is, yes. Yeah, okay. it's clear about that.
Okay.
It says concrete blocks on the map behind that. And old farm equipment and debris.
You know, I couldn't read that, so.
Yeah.
Yes, it calls those concrete blocks the
concrete blocks.
They look like they're round, but maybe they're not.
Google can't get in closer for us, Sarah.
Yeah.
You're so spoiled. They're from space.
It looks more than concrete blocks, doesn't it?
Maybe you should buy drones.
Nice. Drones.
Hmm.
It looks like it's being farmed too, doesn't it?
It looks like, yes, some of it.
In the back there.
In the back there.
There's a garden or something, yeah.
Well, it says something about spruce trees. I'm wondering if there's somebody put in some Christmas trees.
Well, there's a, if you look at this, you can see all the individual little.
Okay.
The income from leasing it annually go to.
Cultivated cannabis.
Conservation?
It's generally, the Ag Commission generally prefers to do, work instead of, so a labor payment instead of an actual cash payment. The cash payment per year will be so small, it's not really even worth collecting, so having the farmer do something either on this parcel or on some other city owned parcel instead.
Well, it's derelict now, it's an eyesore, it's just accumulating. It looks like sort of agricultural trash and it's being used illegally, without.
Other than that,
we just wanted friendly relations with the Soviet Union and, it seems like a very nice thing for the city to pick up for a low price and then turn over to responsible use.
Yeah. I certainly agree with that. I'm just wondering how much, because it's not clear from this, how much due diligence has been done and whether, because the land has not yet been, it's just anticipated that it's going to be surplus by the state, right? And needed to the city. So I just would like to know that the money's not going to be used on a parcel that's going to create a war with the neighbor. It's got.
Well, the neighbors won at the moment, so I mean, the worst that's going to happen is that field above it is going to be.
Slightly smaller.
It
depends on how you share it out.
So this is not surplus to the city at this point in time, correct, Sarah?
It's not owned by the city at this point.
Yeah, it's just the legislation's been filed and there's all this, it's anticipated. So we're being asked to fund something that isn't yet in city hands.
So then the question of whether or not there is contamination there is not clear at all.
I don't know if the city's done any kind of investigation.
Yeah, any survey on that?
And Sarah, you're being very silent on this.
No, I would imagine, well, I know Wayne would do that before actually taking title to it. I don't know if it's been done yet.
So we don't own it. We don't know how much stuff is on it, but we're being asked to fund the restoration of it.
Yeah, I mean, we wanted these small grants to be quick if it was simple, and I'm just thinking this is unfortunately maybe not quite as simple a situation as we had in our minds, and I'm feeling like it may all just be wonderful, and that I'd like to understand before voting in favor.
Well, the underlying
idea is great.
As I read the proposal, William writes two checks, one to a forest operation that clears all the wood out.
Yep.
And does whatever it wants with it. And then writes another check to probably a metal scrap person who clears off all the debris. And each of them is about $3,000. And then it's an open, barren piece of land that can be leased to a farmer.
Depends on what that stuff really is there, though.
What the stuff what?
That's all that stuff. I mean, if the cars, yes, I understand, but I.
Well, I assume he's had somebody look at it and they said, oh, I can clear it. I can clear the metal for $3,000.
I'd like to know that.
So, I mean, I take your point. I'd hate to do it, but somebody's willing to do it for $3,000.
maybe we need to consider it with the other grants.
I can't hear you.
Maybe we need to do the same thing we did with the paper.
Chris?
I'd be pleased to consider this when it's in city's hands.
I agree. I don't want to be funding something that we do not own. Put the cart before the horse.
So waste of holding the money that in essence won't be used if that's the case.
Sir, can you remind me, can somebody bring us a request for a small grant at any time?
No.
It only...
At the start of our cycle.
Only at the start of the cycle.
So there's an expedited process, Rick.
It's not, we've never had one for small grants, but there's no reason we couldn't apply the same thing.
Yeah.
Is this a cart horse issue? In other words, does the city have to show that it can clear the land before the state will give it to us?
I wouldn't think so.
Okay.
It is surplus to the state. They definitely don't want it for anything. I think it's just a matter of when is the legislature actually going to take a vote on it.
Chris?
No, it's just in the past when we've had discussions about the state parcel down across from Smith Volk, the understanding was is they just convey it as is, and it's up to us to decide how we want to deal with it. That one is problematic because there's almost certainly hazardous materials on it and it became a cleanup issue. But what the state's position was, you get it.
You do.
You deal.
Further discussion on this?
I'm trying to figure out whether I certainly want more information. I'm trying to figure out whether I want to say not until the city owns it. And I don't know what the likelihood is of that moving forward. Do you have experience with that, Sarah?
Generally, once it's filed, they do act on it within the year, but that could be any time during the year. I don't know if it gets before the summer or after the summer.
Yeah, and I guess I don't see the urgency to do that now.
Right.
Okay, thanks.
Any other discussion? So the motion on the floor is to fully fund this restoration project. All those in favor? All those opposed? So the motion fails 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, right? 3, 4, 5, 6. 1 to 6. Is there a motion to kick this into the general cycle?
That simply, among other things, gives us another 6 weeks when maybe we'll actually get a hold of it. I mean, the piece of property.
In theory.
It would give us a chance to get more information from Wayne. He may actually know something about, if he filed this now, as opposed to waiting for our next cycle, maybe he knows something about when this is going to go.
Right, but we can do cleanup next cycle.
Okay.
Yeah,
that's true. Yes, that's true.
It's not an acquisition.
You can pick any time.
It's not an acquisition issue. It's
right.
There's no fuse burning or anything else. So.
Right.
Correct.
Right. Yeah.
He said it should be finalized during this legislative session.
Which goes through the June
30th. Yeah. Yeah.
Just by way of explanation, because I obviously respect my colleagues, both, but. If the sale didn't from the state to, or if the gift from the state to the Northampton didn't occur, obviously the money would be recoverable by CPC. And secondly, Wayne has always been very reliable in following through on the requests for projects that he's made. So I have no question but that it will, if funded, it would be utilized appropriately. But I have to see the point about owning it first, so let's wait.
In another 6 months,
yeah.
We come back.
Yeah.
Is there a motion to kick this into the general fund and ask Wayne to speak to it in the next few weeks? Would anyone like to make that motion?
No.
Okay. Moving right along to our third and final one, which is TPS purchase.
Yes.
For the cons. And I assume for Sarah, right? Is this something you would?
There is a half-time person who works just doing land management.
And so, speak in support of it.
Let's make, how about a motion first?
I would move to support it and.
Fully funded at $500?
Yes.
Second.
All right, Dave. Part of the discussion, I'd like to say that I think that it's, it obviously probably one of the smallest applications that have come before us, not that that should guarantee its success, but it is a reasonable and valuable tool. One thing I would say is the CPA is, should be money spent that the city would not otherwise be spending on its typical and normal operation. And even though this is a very tiny amount of money, I would say that this should be a regular part of the city planning department's tool basket. And so I feel like we're buying the city a GPS when the city really should have its own GPS. I don't mind it because of its small dollar amount, but perhaps I would suggest that the city, the part of our stipulation is that the city makes it available for any responsible civic use that involves, or say by the Conservation Commission, by planning, by historical, by any body of the city that can use this, because we're not supposed to be using city money to subsidize the operations of the normal operations of the city board.
Other folks? Other discussion? Sarah, can you speak to the antiquity of the existing GPS stuff? Is that
it's? I've been here. I don't really use it, but I've been here 7 years, and it's been here longer than that.
Is this something that a cell phone can't do?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, I don't know.
I mean, a cell phone is better than the one that the planning department currently has. But an ideal one has a lot more functions and mapping capabilities.
Why isn't there an opportunity to request this through the normal process of city budgeting for supplies for that department?
I don't know. I think it's a tight year. Some other types of negotiations and those types of things just weren't available this year.
I think he's assuming that since there's been all this property that the city wasn't part, there's been all this acquisition that needs to be dealt with. He's rolling it into that process.
He meaning Wayne?
Yeah.
I think it's a great idea to get the GPS, but I really agree with David that this is really sliding across that line to sort of things that the city should, I know it's difficult, but find a way to do it. So I think it's not appropriate.
Yeah, because after all, a pen is also a great idea. A pen is such a bright grant, but I don't see a
that's
pen.
That's actually coming up.
I know. GPS and a quill pen. No, but it's a piece of equipment. It's a supply necessary for the operations of that office. They have one that's very old.
That's why I was trying to find some way to make it more democratically accessible. Mm-hmm. Because access to the public is a part of what we do. Without being irresponsible about it. But.
I still think it's on the wrong side of that line.
Yeah.
Nice try, but.
Yeah.
I'm not going to be doing it.
Does anyone else want to speak to that? To what David has brought up? Should this be a routine part of city expenditures and not something that is funded by us, is the question. Any further discussion on this? Okay, ready to go. All those in favor of funding? All those opposed? All those abstaining? So the motion fails on a 1-2-5-1. One in favor, five opposed, and one abstention.
We're ornery this meeting, aren't we?
Yeah. Bring up those small crap. You hear me queuing on? You want to see them? Oh. All right. Well, that was all very interesting. Okay, so we have one of these three that, oh, I guess we could also bring, say, this would be kicked up into the general. Since we've done that with the other two, we should be fair, I suppose. Is there a motion to kick this into the general?
No.
Would anyone like to make that motion?
My recommendation to the applicant would be that it needs to be presented as part of some special project that's outside of the typical routine operation and plan for.
All right, thank you.
If the Conservation Commission wanted to do trail planning and trail mapping, you know, that might be something that was unusual and different, but.
Yeah.
But, you know, just.
Right, outside the norm would be a request to buy six, which now gets it a much larger. Careful what you ask for.
All right, moving on. Sarah, you put this down. Procedures for projects exceeding our memorandum of understanding criteria.
Yes. So, when I talked to Brian a little bit about this, and he suggested I put it on an upcoming agenda, so I did. So when a contract is getting to the end of its term, those funds will essentially turn into a pumpkin. There's no way an applicant can access CPA funds without a valid contract. I can't put any invoices through. The funding isn't available until there is a contract extension. With an MOU, that doesn't happen. So we have several projects that are over the 3 years, still making good progress, but don't have a current MOU. And it's been the past practice of the committee just to sort of let them keep going, but some of them are getting a little bit older, and I was just wondering what the committee wanted to do with those. Do you want reports from me as to what they are and how much funding is left, or do you want to hear from the applicants, or what's your pleasure?
That's a good question, sir, because we've sort of followed your guidance in this regard, and I know there have been times when projects were funded have resulted in MOUs, and other times when they've been resulted in contracts, and I guess I wasn't terribly clear on the significance of the difference, and I assume they're relatively equivalent. Why have you identified some as MOUs and some as contracts?
Anything intra-city is an MOU because the city can't enter into a contract with itself. So Pulaski Park, example, that's over $1 million is an MOU, but then DPW has to enter into contracts with their separate vendors. And anything exterior that's less than $10,000, it can also be an MOU, although it's not required to be. It's much easier.
Very good.
Say the last part again. Anything
less than $10,000. So the small grants by design are all MOU because it's a lot simpler, easier to access.
That was actually clear. Thank you.
Sure.
So, following past practices, if it was an MOU that exceeded the three-year time period, we're essentially leaving it up to Sarah and planning staff to make that call as to whether to simply extend it without coming to us. We could end that policy and ask at the end of 3 years, whether it's an MOU or a contract, that request should come back to this committee.
When we say come back, is there sort of a middle ground where we'd be given like a formal update from your office, like all, status?
All of the applicants provide annual reports, and if there's a project that's not moving forward, then staff will follow up with them and sort of say, well, what are you doing? Are you really going to use this?
Right, but what I'm thinking about is sort of like just one page that's got a list of everything that's out there.
Sure.
When it was supposed to have, you know, where we are in the process.
Yeah.
Yeah, that would be easy to do.
Maybe expenditures to date so that we can see there's actually some movement.
Yeah.
Are there certain
I don't want to create a silly hurdle.
It's a good suggestion.
But a cheat sheet for us would be, I think, would be useful.
That's a good idea.
Yeah, I agree.
And is your thought then that if we had concerns that about a particular project, we could flag it, and then that might bring it out of your, Sarah's, your normal list of...
Right, because if, you know, if I can look at three of these going back, I can get a little bit of history about where a program's moving or not.
On a related or slightly different note, I think, if an MOU has been unfulfilled in 3 years, we really need to sit down and discuss it. Perhaps there doesn't need to be a curtain drawn on another contract, but it should, we should certainly understand what's going on, because there's at a minimum, there's membership change within that time period, and we need to get up to speed as what's going on.
Sarah, do you have specific projects that have exceeded 3 year time period that are MOU?
The Memorial Park Fountain is one of them. What else is there? Wayne has a few bike path projects that have some funds remaining for various purposes.
And how much money are we talking about, ballpark, do you know? So the fountain is the little park creation too, correct?
It is, yep.
And that's still a holdup?
The mass development.
Yeah.
But that's moving forward, but a contract's just been signed for the fountain restoration. So Wayne has a New Haven and Northampton Ridge Rail Trail. He makes expenditures pretty regularly, but it's a giant project that goes a long way, so that's been going on for a little bit. APR program. Community Gardens was one, but that was a contract.
All right, so how do we want to proceed with this?
I could put together just a brief summary of each of them for the next meeting, if that would be helpful.
Would that be helpful?
Great.
Yes.
Yeah? So we could revisit this in the next meeting and look at the three outstanding. It looks like APR, fountain restoration, bike path are the MOUs that have exceeded their 3 year time periods. Do we do 3 years with everybody?
We do. 3 years is the maximum contract period, but for MOUs we can go longer if we were so inclined.
So does that, everyone's good with that? Putting this, asking Sarah to prepare that for our meeting on the 15th of March. Speaking of meetings, if we can take a look at our schedule for our CPC meetings. Knowing that we only have 1, 2, 3, actually 4 now with our small grant being kicked up, 4 projects means a little bit less time. So the 15th, our next meeting a month from now, would be our meeting with the applicants, the public comment section, the following one.
And I didn't anticipate a great deal of public comment for these, so I shortened that to allow for some more recommendation discussion.
Mm-hmm. Great. And theoretically, we could be done on the 5th. And not even have to be, again, if we were to move quickly. These meetings do not reflect the visit from the mayor and the city solicitor.
It does not. I haven't heard any response from them about when they'll be ready with draft documents. I know they're sifting through quite a bit now. I don't have a good sense of when.
So that actually could be months?
I don't think it'll be months, but I don't know if it'll be like next week or a month from now.
Okay. So we have no way of knowing that. Does it make sense simply to wait and see, and once they have recommendations?
I think we should reach out to them and try and pin them down on a timeline.
Is that something you would be able to do, Sarah?
I did.
Oh, you did?
I did. I haven't heard back yet, but I did.
Okay, good.
I'll snag, I see the parent all the time, I'll just snag it and see what's going on.
All right, that would be really helpful, thank you. And then we can revisit this again at the next, the wage theft, when to put that in. So do we have questions about these meeting days, these work in our?
I haven't looked at the projects, but what about the site visits?
Sarah, ideas for the, are these?
Are these just easily accessible for?
I mean, the fair housing assessment is a study.
We haven't looked at them at all.
Conservation fund, I'm sure Wayne would be happy to take people out on a tour or anything if they'd like, but there's nothing specific. The Hampshire Inn expansion project might be one that people haven't seen. And I don't know how accessible that is. And they want a lot of money.
They want a lot of money.
How much they want?
We don't have that.
Half a million dollars.
Whoa.
I assume you told.
Yes, they absolutely know that there are funding constraints. And that this could not be funded even with bonding.
Yeah, so.
The other possible site visit would be to the Lathrop stuff.
Yeah, that's true.
Take a look at that. So it really looks like two possible site visits. Hampshire Inn and Lathrop. Do we want to try to come up with a, generally we've done a Saturday morning. Would want that after the meeting with applicants, does that make sense, or before? Before it's gonna be snowing for Lathrop. Would be the issue with that. Does it help folks to have the site visits before we meet with applicants?
Yes, I think so.
March 15th is a Wednesday, so the Saturday before would be the 8th, 9th, 10th, 11th?
11th, yeah. Or if Saturdays aren't good for people, since we already have the 15th booked on our calendars, it might, if people are around, maybe just do a site visit before the meeting? Saturdays haven't worked.
Yeah, that's
generally people
good
don't show up.
I would be okay with that. The Wednesday the 15th.
Darkness in Lathrop.
March, when's, daylight savings time starts on that Sunday, the 12th, so less dark.
Less dark, yeah, because it.
Spring ahead.
Yep.
Oh, I hate spring ahead.
Spring ahead.
I'd rather fall back. Okay, so there's a proposal to.
Yeah.
Thinking that we're gonna have light.
And less snow.
It's another.
Possibly.
And still snow, at least we could see the trailheads, there's folks who went. March 15th, at what time then? 5 o'clock?
5 at Lathrop, and then, yeah.
Sure.
Hampshire Inn after that.
Yeah?
Yeah.
And you will send reminders out to us?
Yeah.
All right, that's a great suggestion, thank you. So it's really two visits. Hampshire Inn, which is, I'm trying to remember where.
It is right next to Historic Northampton.
Yeah.
Okay. Right on Bridge Street. On the same side of the road?
Yeah.
It's on the other, it's on the far side.
Oh. Okay. Anything else about the meeting schedule? We should be able to move quickly through our discussion certainly in a quicker fashion than last time. Okay, moving right along. Other business not foreseen when agenda was published. Is there any? No, is there a motion to adjourn?
Move.
A second.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Discussion.
Okay.